And so the band guys get up and they're trying to get up those windows open. They finally got them open, you know, just a little bit. And the winds come in and everybody sits down and says, "Oh man, this really feels great." And Harry's in there and he says, "Well, I just hope we don't hit a swarm of bees." And my dad says, "Yeah, or any flying elephants."
This happened a long time ago, and very few people know that Hovey Lister used to play golf. He was a great golfer, and in Atlanta he was playing, and he got down one of these big, deep sand traps, and he couldn't get out. He had a caddy working with him, you know, and he couldn't get out. He'd swung at it 5 or 6 times. Finally, his caddy said, "I tell you what, Mr. Lister, you grab you a handful of sand, and next time I'll throw the ball at you."
That was Vestal Goodman waging a vocal duel with Johnny Cook. And to be honest with you, I don't know who won. Maybe it was the one-man band piano player, Wally Varner.
And the joy of this day was watching these one-of-a-kind pioneers interacting with the young people who had grown up on their music. One of these gospel music kids was Russ Taff, who's lived long enough by now to be gaining some perspective of his own.
Why it should be.
were moments when this day was particularly tough for two precious friends, Lily Fern Weatherford and Ann Downing, who, when we were together just a few months before, were singing with their husbands. But it was a testimony to the truth of these songs that these two came with a song still in their hearts, a song made sweeter by the reality of God's presence through the hard times.